Okay, now I'm joining.
Sorry, I got disconnected. So today we are going to read Pigeons by Lillian Moore. So who is Lillian Moore? Let's read about him. Here is a very small description about Lillian Moore. Lillian Moore is the author of a children's book of poetry and prose, such as I'll Meet You at the Cucumbers and Don't Be Afraid. Amanda, she lives in Seattle, Washington. So where is Washington?
Washington is in the U.S., it's the capital city of U.S.
Correct. So this is about Lillian Moore, and this poem is very easy. The words are very easy and short. Who would like to read? Turn on your camera and raise your hand. Very good. Nehita, unmute and read. Read the first five lines.
Okay, ma'am. Pigeons are city folk content to live with concrete and cement.
Five lines over. Okay. Thank you. So pigeons are city folk. What is the meaning of folk? Yes, Nimira.
Ma'am, city folk means people who are from the city.
Yes, a group of people. Folk means a group of people. So the poet has compared Fijian with the city people. Content to live with concrete and cement. Content means, who can tell me the meaning of content? Raise hand. Keep your camera on. Okay, give it again. What is the meaning of content?
Content means they feel happy.
Yes, happy to live in the concrete and cement world. Now, next five lines. Who is willing to read? Okay, Nimira. No one is interested today. What happened? The weather is so good here.
Excuse me, ma'am.
The seldom tries the sky. A pigeon never sings of hill and flower head.
Okay, stop. Stop here. Thank you. They seldom try the sky. What is the meaning of these lines? Who can I explain? I wish you all to explain this poem because this is very easy poem. I want to hear the summary from you all. Who can explain? They seldom try the sky. Seldom means very rarely. They hardly fly
Not
in the
often.
Sky. Yes, they don't often fly in the sky. You'll notice if you observe a pigeon, you'll notice that they don't fly a lot. Next, who is interested? Nobody is raising hand. Is it very tough?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, we're speaking. Raise hand, please. Turn on your camera so that I can recognize you. Turn on your camera and speak.
Ma'am, now only I joined. No, ma'am, I don't know what's the lesson. Can you say me the lesson name?
Yes, Krishna Sri, we are reading Pigeons today by okay. Lillian Moore, and the page number is 15. We just finished first five line. Now I'm explaining the next five line.
Okay, ma'am.
You just continue from here. At the end of this, I'll explain again. Okay, don't worry. So, pigeons don't fly very much. They cover only short distances. A pigeon never sings of hill and flowering hedge. What is the meaning of this line? Pigeon never sings of hill and flowering hedge. Mukula, Neha, can you explain? Neha, can you explain this line? What is the meaning of flowering hedge? Raise hand, everyone. Don't worry if your answer is wrong. Nothing is going to happen. We'll just discuss. Okay. Nimira,
Ma'am, flowering hedge means a bush which has flowers on it.
Yes, if we go in some houses, we can see flowering hedge. They fence their house using small bushes, right? And they cut it with shape, and special in garden. Have you ever seen a maze, M-A-Z-E, in garden? Yes. Those boundaries are called flower, plant boundaries are called hedges. Okay, let me show you if possible. Maybe I have a picture here.
Ma'am, can we say it is like flowery shrub?
It is flowery shrub, but maintained in a line. And we can see it in valleys and also in houses. Okay, let me show you the picture. Everyone has seen this thing. Especially in gardens. Let me share my screen. Can you all see my screen now?
No, ma'am.
This one. No, ma'am. It's showing please start minicam.
Please start minicam.
Oh.
Yes, ma'am. It's showing that. Or choose another video source.
We can't see you, ma'am.
Okay, it is not visible. What? Okay, one second, let me ask the solution.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, who is willing to read next? Okay, someone is sharing the screen. Nimira is sharing. If everyone can see it. Yes, it is the correct picture, Nimira. Very good. Yes, Nehita, you have any doubt, ask me.
No, ma'am. I'm willing to read, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, Nimira, for sharing. Yes, Nehita, read the next lines.
But busily commutes from sidewalk to its ledge. OPGN, what a waste of wings.
Yes. So we'll never find. So let's sum up the poem once again. Pigeons are city folk. Here the poet compared the pigeon as the city people. And pigeons don't fly too much. And you'll never find a pigeon singing over the valley, flowering valley and hills. But you can see them talking with each other. Communicates means they're chirping or tweeting busily from sidewalk. Have you seen sidewalk in the cities? Pavement, what we call pavement for walking. Yes, you'll often find pigeons are sitting there, or if you notice big buildings, they will be sitting on the ledge. You have any idea what is ledge? Windowsill, you know windowsill? Like there is a small place below window where you can keep small things sometimes. Yes, or a box is made around a window, that is called windowsill or ledge. On top of a door also, we have a small place, that is called ledge. Yes, Nehita.
Ma'am, where the horizontal and narrow surface is there of the wall or something.
Yes, we can call the door frame or the window frame, right? In every building, there is a frame type. with various design, there birds often sit, right? You can see crows or sparrows sitting there. So, and basically pigeons make their houses in the windowsill or the ledges, right? And in the last line, the poet said, what a waste of wings. So how many of you desire to have wing in your life? We are a human being with two hands and two legs, right? Do you ever desire to have wings? Raise hand that I wish I had a wing, right? Why? Why you wish so? Because we have bus, train, airplane, still you wish to have a wing? Okay, Rishita, tell me.
Ma'am, because I wanted wings, because if we want to go somewhere, we have to go by car or any vehicle. So it will be polluted. So if we have wings, we can roam where we want. We can go where we want without no pollution.
But cycle also, if you use bicycle, it also doesn't create any pollution.
Yes, ma'am.
Why particularly you need wing? Okay, let's think about it. I'll ask.
We can plan.
Yes. I'll come back to you. Okay. Next, Nehita.
Unmute.
Yes,
ma'am. Ma'am, because I want a freedom that I want to fly myself.
Okay, anywhere you want to fly, right?
Yes.
Very good answer. Next, Snitika.
Ma'am, I want wings because I can go anywhere. And ma'am, nowadays everyone are using bikes and cars, so because of it, it is the earth is polluting a lot.
But nowadays that eco-friendly scooters are available, no? Battery scooty, battery car.
Yes, ma'am, but also we are also losing the battery.
It's fine, we can recharge it using solar system. Solar is also very harmless energy, right? Eco-friendly energy. So why particularly wing? Think about your answer. Okay, now Nimira.
Ma'am, I would like wings, as if we want to go on the flights, it will cost money, right? If we had wings, we could just go freely.
But you can go by train also, it will cost you less money. And you need not to flap your wing, right? It is a very tiresome job, I think, for birds. Flapping the wings continuously.
Yes, ma'am, but it will
energy.
Be very fun.
Okay, it will be
very
fun. Good. Next, Mukula, what is your answer?
Ma'am, I want to fly high, ma'am.
Just you want to fly high. Then you can try to be a jet rocket pilot. They can fly higher than birds. Why particularly wing? Okay, anyone else? What about Arjun, Shreya, Rudved, Avinav and Krishna Sri? Your videos are off. Turn on your video and participate. Yes, Arjun. Do you ever wanted wing? Have you ever wished for a wing? Yes. Yes, Arjun. Arjun is still thinking. Okay, next I'll move to Shreya. Shreya, please turn on your video and answer. If you wish to have a wing.
So we can use wings and we can fly high.
Shreya, can you answer a little louder?
Nowadays we have airplanes polluting.
Yes.
So we can
That's a very good reason to have wings. Nowadays we are affected by coronavirus, so very touch free. we can fly and go from one place to another. Very good answer. So overall, everyone gave very unique answers. Any doubt, Neha, then raise hand. I got your answer. Okay. Okay, Nehita, tell me. Yes, Nehita. Unmute, please. Press the unmute button. Press the unmute button, Nehita. Yes.
Ma'am, from that time, Kundana is telling you to admit, ma'am. Admit okay. In this meeting.
Done. Okay. Let's continue with the poem. The poem is clear, everyone. Show me thumbs up if it is clear. Very good. Now, come to the question part. Can you tell how has the poet used a metaphor to help you to look at pigeons in a different way? Now, who can tell me this answer? Which metaphor is used in this poem? Pigeons are compared with what? Very easy. Look at the first stanza. I want the answer from Kundana. Kundana will get the first chance. Kundana, in this poem, some metaphor is used. Pigeon is compared with something. What is that thing? Read the first five lines and you will get your answer. I think everyone is ready, right? Those are continuously in this class, they know the answer. Yes, good to see two hands. Arjun, are you ready? And what happened? Rudved, Krishna Sri, and Shreya. And where is Sanjana today? Kundana, can you answer? Have you got it?
Poem name, ma'am. Poem name. What is the poem name, ma'am?
Pigeons.
Ma'am?
Pigeons. Kundana, you just joined? I'll ask Arjun now. Arjun, can you answer this question? Arjun, can you answer this question? Pigeons are compared to what? Just read the first five line. It is written there. Okay, Rishita.
Ma'am, concrete and cement.
Is it correct answer? Show her thumbs up if it is correct, if you agree. Okay, so many thumbs down. Rishita, read the lines. Next, I'll move to Smitika. Smitika, yes, unmute and answer this one. Unmute, press the unmute button. I think Smitika is having some technical issue. Now, I'll move to Nimira. Yes.
Ma'am, in this poem, the pigeons are compared to the city folk.
Very good. Everyone agree? I think everyone got the answer. Very good. In the second line, pigeons are city folk. It is a metaphor. Now, next question. Why can't pigeons sing of hills and flowering hedge? Who can answer this one? Why can't pigeons sing of hills and flowering hedge? Only one student is raising hand. What about other? What do you feel of pigeons? Yes, raise your hand. Okay, Rishita.
Ma'am, a pigeon never sings or hill and flowering hedge because they are busily commute.
Okay. Now, Nimira, what is your answer?
Ma'am, the pigeons can't sing of hills and flowering hedges as they don't sing very often. But instead of singing, they will be busily commuting with the other pigeons and other birds.
Okay, so.
Ma'am?
Give me a moment, please. Yes. Now, who would like to answer the same? Okay, Nehita.
Ma'am, they don't sing. They only on, not often, rarely they sing because they are very busy to commute with other ones by in the sidewalk.
Okay, think in a different way. So, pigeons, where do they live? Think about that. Pigeons live in a city, right? Mostly they live in people's houses or in cities. That is the reason they can't sing in the hill and in the flowering hedges. Pigeons are not wild bird, right? They are mainly city birds like crow, sparrow. That is the reason. So answer should be pigeons never sing of hill and flowering hedges because they live in cities. Number three, what does the poet mean when she says that a pigeon busily commutes? Now you answer. What is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of busily commutes? Yes, Nehita.
Ma'am, busily commute means they are very busy with talking with others.
Correct. Okay, Smitika, what is your answer? Everyone can share the same answer in your own way. Yes, Smitika.
Ma'am, busily commute means they will be very busy and they will travel back and forth regularly.
Yes, and they chart busily commute means pigeon, you will never see a pigeon sit and singing or twittering in a on the branch of a tree, right? They fly very short and they, you will hardly hear any pigeons call. Kundana raised hand. Yes, Kundana, any doubt?
No, ma'am, I wanted to say that answer only.
Okay, what is your answer? You can say again. Okay.
The same answer, ma'am. Pigeons will busily communicate with the other pigeons and it won't care anything which is nearby.
Yes, correct answer. So, the concept is clear, right, everyone? Show me thumbs up if the concept is clear. Okay, now say what you think. What does the poet convey through the last three lines of this poem? You can tell me the answer in your way, in your word. The last three lines is very interesting. Oh, pigeon, what a waste of wings. We just had a discussion on this. You can tell me again the answer. Arjun, would you like to share now? What is your opinion? Say a few words. What do you understand by this line? What a waste of wings. Why the poet said it is a waste for pigeons to have wings? Yes, Nivira.
Ma'am, by the last three lines of this poem, the poet conveys saying that the pigeons, they don't use their wings. So what's the point of them having wings when they don't even fly at all?
Correct. Anyone else who would like to share the answer? Yes, Kundana.
Ma'am, the poet is saying that the pigeons won't fly, only then why they need wings? Their wings are waste of wings.
Nehita?
Ma'am, the same answer. They don't need to fly. And also, they are city people. Why they need to fly?
Okay, so in short, we can say here poet compared the pigeon as people, city people, and they don't also take long flight. They fly very rarely. That's why many people, many of us desire to have a wing to have a long journey, right? But pigeons, for pigeons, the wing is such a waste. the answers are clear. Which other birds? Okay, read the next one. Have you noticed any pigeon in your neighborhood? I think everyone's answer is yes. Where do they like to sit? We already discussed in window sill and on the sidewalk, on in the ledges we can see them, right? Which other birds are you sure to find in a busy city? Now tell me some name of city birds. We already discussed, right? Which birds are commonly seen in cities, especially in cities? Yes, Nitika.
Ma'am, we see little sparrows, ma'am.
Yes.
And parrots also.
Yes, parrots.
Yeah, ma'am.
We cannot call parrots city bird. It is actually wild. Sometimes it may come to rest for some for a while in season. Like if you have a garden, then you can see parrot, but hardly it can be seen in cities. Yes, Nehita.
Ma'am, I mostly see in my neighborhood crow, ma'am. Crows.
Uh-huh.
Crows, pigeons, and these all birds. Like.
Yes, Nehita.
Ma'am, I mostly see pigeons, crows, sparrows, like these type of birds, ma'am.
Yes, so let me add few more names like dove. Yes, Nimira. You would like to
know
another name?
Yes, ma'am. In my neighborhood, I see pigeons, sparrows, crows, and parrots as well, ma'am.
Okay. Kundana, any new name?
Ma'am, in my neighborhood, I can see crows, pigeons, doves, small little sparrows, ma'am.
Okay.
And crows.
Rudvesh now. Rudved.
Ma'am, I saw total animals only, ma'am. I went to forest.
Okay. In forest, we can see all kind of animal, but these are the common city bird. If you go to my hometown, if I come to Warangal, Hyderabad, wherever I go, I can see crow, sparrow, dove, pigeon. These are the common birds. And in some places, you can see parrots, vultures, right? Or hawk.
Ma'am, I saw total animals, ma'am, in forest.
That's great. Great,
ma'am.
Yes.
So our time is over. This poem was very interesting. It is already 9:42. I'm going to close the session. Read the poem and learn the tough word. Tomorrow we'll start with coursework. Okay. So bye bye. Take care. Have a great day ahead.